My name is Eddie Daniels. I play the clarinet, the saxophone, and the flute, which I played for many, many years, and then I kind of put it away for a little while. It suddenly came back to me, and I'm in love again with the flute. So you're going to hear some flute playing on this album, which is the music of Ivan Lins, beautiful Brazilian composer, just romantic. When I hear his music, it makes me feel like kisses, kissing your loved one, the sensitivity of subtlety.
I'm a very big fan of the music of Ivan Lins. For many, many years, I've enjoyed playing his music. It's very romantic, but it's also adventurous, and it calls upon Eddie and me to be creative, to listen to each other, and to have a kind of musical dialogue.
This group of players was phenomenal. And I'm not talking about guys that worked on my thing only. I mean, everybody that's involved in this project, it's a cast of champions for sure.
My mission was to reharmonize the music. The whole idea behind it is to create something in the spirit of jazz. I was trying to give Ivan's music an other profile.
We have the Harlem String Quartet, so beautiful. They were on our first album, Heart of Brazil. Probably the best string quartet ever.
Happy when we got this call from George to do a second album with Eddie. Not only we love the result of the first album, but we really like working with Eddie and with all of these fantastic arrangers and group of musicians.
There was a conversation at some point, how about if we actually either write or just put a little bit more meat to the quartet writing. All these musicians are getting to know the Harlem Quartet and they decide, you know what, these guys can do it, so let's write even higher parts for them.
We met Eddie when we were in Santa Fe for a concert. The Chamber Music Society we were there performing with told us he was in town and asked if we'd be interested in collaborating some of our jazz tunes with Eddie. And we said, sure.
We were sharing the stage with him, and it was a mostly classical concert. We included him on some of our jazzier arrangements, and we also premiered a piece for clarinet plus string quartet. And ever since then, we've stayed in touch, and we've done so many projects together.
I made my living as a musician in New York as a studio rat by working for Bob James and Dave Grusin. They're both musicians that I respected so much when I worked with them.
It's intimidating to have the likes of Bob James, Dave Grusin, and Kuno Schmidt in the room as you're playing, but they're so open and wonderful people that they just want you to be you. They were open to my ideas and the music, and it seemed to make sense with the arrangements. I'd say this moment is probably one of the highlights in my young career.
Even though we were shifting it away from the kind of pure Brazilian feel, we wanted to make it a natural American jazz feel as well.
It's jazz, it's Brazilian music, there's pop, there's a lot of different influences. It's a project that will please everybody. I reharmonized all tunes. I had longer introductions, more space for improvisation.
This record will appeal to music lovers, no matter what genre they favor. It's a cornucopia of colors and flavors.
You're gonna hear some saxophone that will make you cry. And some clarinet playing with the warmth of the clarinet and the flute just kind of took me over. As soon as I got back to it, it was like a kiss in the night holding this flute, and I couldn't get it away from my face. I just started playing it and I had to keep it there. I hear Yvonne's voice on a lot of these songs, and it's so beautiful and touching, and it brings back romance, tenderness, love, holding your sweetheart's hand. We're all holding hands. Guys can hold your hands. You can hold the paw of your dog also, holding paws. Yvonne, I hope you're going to love it and feel that I and the musicians and the writers added something to your music that rings true to you and makes you happy.